Well, people often ask me, how did you start She Is Safe? Why did you start She Is Safe? So I want to take just a minute to talk about that, how God moves ordinary people into what He wants for them to do. You may have heard a bit of my story. I was rescued from the home of a pedophile. I am a survivor of commercial sexual exploitation by my father, and I was such a lost girl. But I was drawn in by some beautiful Christians that I met, and I discovered a whole new life and a sense of purpose. Many years later, my husband and I and our two daughters lived in East Africa. We were there just to share Christ and help the indigenous church grow. And it was there in about 1985 when I first learned that girls were being sold. I'd never heard of such a thing. I didn't know what to call it, but I would write letters home about what I was learning. At the same time, God was introducing me to some amazing African women who also had a heart to free and equip these girls. They wanted a whole different life for them in Christ. And so I learned from them that there were small things that we could do that could make all the difference in the mindset of families, and of course for the girls and boys who are coming on up. And so that was the seed that was planted in my heart all of those years ago. And when we came back to the United States, it was about in 2002 when we, a group of praying friends, said, well, let's just launch out by faith. And so She Is Safe was born. And we began in just one small place that we knew about, that it was common for girls to be abused and sold. And that became our focus. Where are the places where it's pretty much the norm for girls to be sold? And oh, you can imagine how that tapped into my memories of my own life. Now I get to look these women and girls in the face and say, there's a whole new life for you, and you have amazing insights to share. Let's grow together. And we have, with so many women and girls who are now, they were once victims and survivors, and now they are more than conquerors through Christ who loves them. I thank you for joining in and wanting to be a part of breaking the chains for other women and girls. They're just waiting to hear the good news.